Good morning to the welcome and to the heart and soul programs of India Bridge to Life Family Counseling Ministry. So as in we are in spending time in every Saturday and think of something what we can do for our families. Again, we have to keep it in mind that you are in your home. So now you are more fresh. Now you can feel free. Now you are inhaling oxygen, pure oxygen. And now your whole body system, your immune system, your nervous system, your conscious system, every system is alive and alert. So it's a blessed time for us to spend time together to think of the valuable things in our life. Bridge to Life is always standing for us, for you people. Anybody wants in that kind of assistance to correct your family life or to strengthen your family life, a kind of advices or sometimes psychological help or a family life problems or sexual problems or relationship problems or career problems, you can approach us. So you can contact us through your telephone or mobile or email, you can do it. So thank you so much for watching today's program, because we are going to listen something very crucial in our life. So we are expressing our gratitude to you because many of you are calling us and standing with us. Therefore, we are continuing our mission. So family is a common subject for us. Everything is coming out of family. God instituted family first. Therefore, we have to separate some moments. How are you going to show your face in your home? So we were discussing about the topic parenting. Today, I would like to share with you something. The vital lessons for life. Vital lessons for life. We are learning daily basis. Nobody is born as a perfect person. We are all learned through our situation, surroundings, from our teachers, from our friends, from our society. So we have to update our knowledge day by day. So let's ask God to give us God's wisdom to deal with the family subject, because God is blessing every family. Thank you. So let's pray. Father, we love you this morning. May you guide us to think something which is crucial for us. Take care of us, Father. In Jesus' precious name we pray now. Amen. There's a word in the New Testament. Colossians is one of the book in New Testament says, chapter 2, verse 3. Colossians chapter 2, verse 3. In him, all hidden treasures of wisdom and knowledge. In him. Who is that person? In him, all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge. We need both. Wisdom we need, knowledge we need. But if you look a person, then we will get it. That's what it says. In parenting tasks, we need to learn children by focusing on Lord Jesus. How was Jesus and his advisors to me? So, today I would like to help you to learn something. Teach your children to fear their Lord, to fear their God. So we have learned in Psalm 111 verse 10 and also in the Proverb chapter 9 and 10 and the Proverb chapter 1 verse 7 is all talking about the fear of the God is the beginning of the wisdom. That means the knowledge of the Holy One is understanding. So we have no excuse for any parents to not relate to God. Your greatest need for your child is child should live for only few years. Give him a new face. He is the part of God, an everlasting God. Your relationship with your child is an everlasting relationship. Even after your death also, children will remember. It's not for a temporary relationship. It's a long-term relationship. So therefore, we have to tell them this great fact that children should have that kind of reverence for parents. That reverence have two aspects there. This fear has something like a reverence, not a phobia kind of fear. Children always keep parents as a most respected personality in their life. Once they remember that parents are standing as a model for them, they will not depart from it. But the thing is, if the parents are weak, the parents are showing some weakness or the symbol of sins, the children will doubt about it. Then they will change their focus. Therefore, each parents are brilliant enough to show not only their face alone, but the face of Lord Jesus Christ or face of God. When they fix their face on God, they will not depart from that focus. If they are focusing only their parents, the parents are weak. They will make mistake. All parents in this the world, they will make mistake. Even our greatest men in our country also make mistake. They fail to take care of their children. So I have plenty of stories about it, but I don't want to defame their names. They're all legendary figures in many fields. They failed. They failed in their family life. They failed in parenting. But they're a legendary figure in their areas of influence. I don't want to change that focus because you have some good picture about them. Keep it. At least that part is good for them. So, the fear of God that is giving us a more strength in our life, more understanding in our life. Because we have to give them a goal of reverence, a goal of giving respect to parents. Parents are always with them. So, and also tell them that God is not a person to be mocked at all. Nowadays people are mocking at God. What kind of God you are worshipping? What kind of God you are living? What kind of God you are praying? Say, don't mock at your God. In Proverbs chapter 10 verse 27 says, the fear of the Lord prolongs days, but the years of the wicked will be shortened. So this fact we have to tell people. The reverence will give them long life. The wicked people will get only the short life. That's the thing we have to tell people about it. Number one thing is that because of the sin, the people will be having guiltiness and finally they will commit suicide. Who asked Hitler to commit suicide? Nobody asked him. But because of his guiltiness sometimes, or fear of death sometimes, fear of abuse sometimes, he committed suicide. Who asked this Judas Iscariot to commit suicide? Nobody tell him. He himself judged. He believed that he was enough. But his activities made him, his action made him, attitude convicts him that he made a mistake. Why? He didn't have any focus on God. Even though he traveled with Jesus many years, he listened to the word of God many years, but nothing in his heart was prepared to focus on God. It's all namesake. They went to people, went to temples and churches without knowing, without having a proper relationship with God. And the second thing, they don't have any fellowship with God. Fellowship and relationship, both are crucial in parenting. If children likes you very much, they will come to your home early. Because they want to spend maximum time with the parents. I know the children coming to our city for studies. They always talking that, anyway, next leave days, academic leave days, I want to spend time with my parents. Then I ask them, why do you want to spend time with the parents? Because they are very close to me. I want to enjoy the time with my parents. So our children need to get such an idea, such a message. Spending time with the parents are a most crucial thing in their life. They like to. So this way we can build a life. Because they love. They love their parents. At the same time, they must love their God. They must help the others also to have a life. Because their real life is lying with the God's fear. That is the source of the life. In Proverbs chapter 14 verse 27 says, the fear of the Lord is a fountain of life. And to turn one away from that foundation, that will snare to death. That is the foundation of life. Connect them to the source of life, that is God. And in 19 verse 23 also says, Proverbs chapter 19 verse 23 says, the fear of the Lord leads to life, and he who has it will abide in satisfaction. He will not be visited with evil. The fear of the Lord leads to life. That means evil will depart from him. So, in parenting, we have to understand that, help our children to love the Lord. Let him to say something about the Lord. Let him passionately think of God. Let him have a relationship with God. so that our child will not waste time. Waste means he is unnecessarily spending time with the evil things. So he will come back to you. And another second thing you have to tell them about, teach your children to guard their mind. Mind is a supreme thing. All perversions are happening in the heart of child, the heart of people. So we have to tell them that guard their minds. In Proverbs chapter 4 verse 23 says, keep your heart with all diligence. Keep your heart with all diligence, and for out of it spring of issues of life. Spring of issues of life that will come out of our heart. And Proverbs chapter 23 verses 7 is emphasizing one big fact. As he thinks in his heart, as he thinks in his heart, so is he. A man is equal to what he thinks in his life, what he always meditate on his heart. So that means his thinking capacity, thinking matter is so crucial. It's not a biological factor alone. It is something more than that. If a person is thinking always evil, no doubt we can say that he will die. Because he is the way of death. So we have to tell our children to guard their mind. That is important for all the parents in the world. The psalmist wrote one thing in Psalm 101 verse 3 says, I will not set things wicked before my eyes. I will decide what should come before my eyes. Many things come into our eyes now. Within a moment, thousands of sights are coming in front of our eyes. But psalmist says, I will set nothing wicked before my eyes. Help them to choose only the best, only the good, only the things which is connected with the life. That's the thing we have to do it. Once upon a time, I got a time to spend time with a student who was studying in the MSW. And when I met him in a college campus, I noticed that this boy was so depressed. Because he was a drug addict. Then I asked him to share with me his life story. He was so angry with me. He asked me, why do you want to know about my all things, all such bad things? Then I asked him, why do you want to use all these drugs and drinks? Then finally he told me that you mind your own business. I say, it's not my business. It's God's business to help you. I'm here to help you. You just share with me. And he asked me, don't institute anything to me new. So what I am thinking, that's what I am. That's already written in the word of God in Psalm 23 verse 7. As he thinks in his heart, so is he. Then after days of my conversation with this man, the beginning he was resisted me not to speak anything personally. But one day he told me that, now I am studying the second final year of my MSW in one of the prestigious colleges. The children decided to enjoy what was the available facilities in that city. They started to drink liquor. The beginning, they used liquor for a few months. One way they enjoyed it. He is from a rich family. He spent money lavishly with other friends, about a 16 people gang. Then the things has come out. their needs was very much, they started stealing the they started a robbery. Then really they realized that their needs are increasing, because maintaining a gang is not an easy thing. So they travel many cities and they started to loot things. Then they went to next phase of life. Next phase was they started to use drug. They were drug dealers. Second step. In that time, he became a more perfect thief and as well as a leader. Everybody started to bow before him. He was able to punish people, and he was able to put his opponents down, everything. And that time he was thinking of some sign artists in the picture in the sign cinema. He started to use weapons. This MSW boy. Then again and again, everything was possible to him. Muscle power, manpower, money power. That was not his own money. It's a looted money. Then again, they started to think of women. So the nights they went to different houses, several adulterous houses. They enjoyed the time there. Nobody was there to keep these children, advise the children. If anybody goes there, it's not easy. And meanwhile, one day I met this young, very strong man in the college situation. I asked him, "Sir, what was your thing? Tell me something about." Then he said, "Don't look at all my life. My life is very, very secret life." Then I asked him, "My question for you is that, whether the way you are adopting your life is leading you to life or leading you to death?" That was a direct question to him. He was trailing inside. My question, I raised to him, "Tell me the answer. Would you be able to answer to me?" Then after a few days of visit, he behaved like a friend to me. He recognized that I am a noble man in that sense. Yes, he told me that, "I believe you, that's what I am willing to talk to you." But he said, "No, this time I won't." I asked him about his family, where out. He said, "No, don't ask such questions." Then, one day, I met one of his gang member, one of the students, and asked that boy, "So your leader is very sad inside. Then how do you know about it?" "Because I am dealing with human problems." But he was not willing to disclose his matters. "If you are sincere to your leader, are you sincere to your leader? If you are sincere to your leader, tell me his problem." It's an indirect way approach the one of the gang leader, one of the gang member. He knows me because I am a regular visitor to that institution. He said that, "Sir, my leader is going to die very soon. You know that? He is having AIDS problem, acquired immune deficiency syndrome. I am telling 100% truth. So he wanted to die soon. He said that I will die within 6 months. Then he is out of control, sir. We can't say anything to him. He is so powerful, so cruel. He is able to manage things and... But you know that he was a married person. His wife is abroad. She is working there. She is sending money to him. Husband. He is a young husband. But now what will happen? This boy is going to die. Then I told that member, why can't you just give me a chance to share with you? How can we get out of it? He said, sir, it is a risky business. But I told him, you must arrange it. You must have sincerity to save your leader. I have some tips with me. I can tell you that. So he told to that leader, I know that this man have some suggestions for you. Why can't we invite him in the midst of us? He asked me that you must come and meet me in my home. Then there I saw that his whole gang member, 16 people. I said that. So we have to keep two ways in our hands. One is to keep our destiny clear, that is to achieve life, achieve the great goal in our life, to be a perfect man. Otherwise, it will go opposite direction. There will be nothing in our life. You have to decide. If you are really going with a good destination in your life, first of all, you think of your God Almighty, one who created you. He is having ownership for you. He can help you. He can repair you. He can heal you. But it only depends on whether you believe it or not. There is no pressure. Second one, think of your parents. How much love they invested in you. How much hope invested in you. Then there's a chance. They are praying for you. They are every day is desiring for you. That will save you. That will protect you. So this man asked me, sir, you have to pray for me. Every day you have to pray for me. I said, I can pray for you, no problem. Then the only question is, shall we all gather together and pray for each other? And they said that, why can't we try that way? We did a lot of mischievous things. We made a lot of mistakes. Why can't you just think of this line, change for a month? Then that started prayer. We started to discuss. No pressure. Feel freedom. So that went on 6 months. Meanwhile, the owner of the college sent a person to me and asked me to meet him personally. And I met him and he said that, what you have done to my boys here? They are all criminalized boys. Now we noticed that, the teachers noticed that, the fellow people noticed that. Last 6 months, no bad report from them. Now what method you use to change these people? I said that, nothing extra. It's all is what is available inside of our life. I talked them about a quality of life, that's all. He said that you come and do it here in our campus for the rest of the students. I did it for some more months in that level. Till their course ends, I did it like that. I thank God for all these children. They are spread all over the world. Now they are serving the society and serving people. So this is a way we can build, give, introduce God to your children and others' children so that they will get a good life. Thank you so much for watching today's Heart and Soul program. May the good God bless you. Thank you so much.
So when the walls come falling down on me. ನೀನು.